Hi, my name is Matthias and we are on the way to the new battery building that is currently under construction in Hermsdorf. I'm group manager at Fraunhofer IKTS, most of you know me already. And I'm really proud to show you this new building today where all these sodium battery activities at Fraunhofer IKTS will happen in the next years. Unfortunately, this is a two-bladed knife today. I'm not able to represent you some laboratories that are under operation at the moment because we are moving at the moment to this new building, but we can have a look inside. If you want to follow me, please come with. This is a historical moment. I will open the door for the first time with my own key. I just need to find it. Where is it? Okay, welcome. Okay, this is one of our biggest labs that we will use in this new building here. All that you can see here is battery equipment for characterization of high temperature sodium batteries. You can see here that everybody has in its lab who's characterizing batteries. We have multi-channel battery testers here. We have over there are test rigs for testing of large cells with high capacity and high currents. Then we have heating chambers as we use it to bring our cells on temperature of 300 degrees Celsius. And right behind here, around the corner, we will have some glove boxes. You can't see them at the moment. They will be delivered in a few weeks. Behind there, all installations are ready. We expect it maybe at the end of January that we will work in this new building here. And altogether, I would say we are approximately 20 to 25 colleagues that will work in this building. And yes, the focus is definitely on high temperature sodium batteries. That means sodium nickel chloride and sodium sulfur batteries. And the whole team will work exclusively in this topic. So I think we are, we have almost the biggest team in Europe that is working on this battery type in only one research institute. The core of this battery technology, the solid electrolyte and the cathode component that we need to assemble the cells, are manufactured in the technical building that is beside this new building, and we will go now to the technical building and have a look inside. Please come in and follow me. And I advise you just to take a look around the first to get an impression of this building. Okay, as you can see, this is definitely not a laboratory building. This is a technical building. This is one of the oldest buildings that we have here in Hermsdorf at the IKTS branch we are at the moment. This building was constructed in the former GDR in the 80s of the last century. So, and everything is almost like it was. As you can see it, it looks a little bit old-fashioned inside, but the technology that we have inside here is brand new and it's operating definitely. And let me take you along the technical chain, the value chain of assembling a sodium beta alumina based sodium nickel chloride battery cell. We will start first in the room where we mix the raw materials for manufacturing the solid electrolytes. And just please follow me. So it's pretty noisy inside here, so I have to speak a little bit louder. In this room, everything starts. That means inside here we prepare the raw material, the feedstocks for the sodium beta alumina electrolytes that we manufacture on our own here at IKTS. You can see here different devices for mixing powders, for milling powders in different sizes. On the table there you can see a small one with a batch size of only 2 kilograms, and the next level over there you can mix powder mixtures with a weight of almost 25 up to 50 kilos depending on the gravity of the material. Okay, beta alumina is a ceramic material, and yes, the most critical aspect for manufacturing a solid electrolyte is the shaping technology. And as you might know, for ceramics there are different technologies available for shaping an electrolyte tube. You can press it, you can extrude it, you can tape cast it, and you can, whatever you want to do is available. A particular technology that we developed at IKTS is the plastic extrusion at room temperature of this material. That means we take the powder from the room you've seen before, and we prepare a stiff plastic mass in such a machine that we call a kneader. We need this feedstock after kneading to do the plastic extrusion step to shape the electrolyte by the plastic extrusion, and I will show you the devices that we have. Okay, this is a brand new machine that we bought last year. This is a plastic extruder with an auger diameter of 80 millimeters. With this machine, we can manufacture solid lead electrolytes in a size, approximately diameter 60 millimeters in a green state, and a length as long as you want to have it. Because this technology is a continuously working process. That means we take our feedstock, the stiff plastic mass that we prepared in the kneader, put it inside here, the mass is transported by this Archimedes screw that you can see here, and here in front of it we place the mouthpiece of this device, and then we do shaping our electrolytes. And the particular thing that we have developed here is that we can close the tube at the one side, and this process is integrated into the extrusion process itself. So after shaping and drying the extruded electrolytes, of course the next critical process we need is the sintering of the electrolyte. You know that we need temperatures of about 1600 degrees Celsius, and therefore we have different kilns in-house. This is one of our biggest kilns, as you can see it here, with a maximum temperature of 1800 degrees C, and inside this kiln we can sinter approximately 50 to 100 electrolytes in only one batch. It takes almost 30 hours to sinter this. And this is definitely not a common size for a research institute. The idea behind this technical building is to be somehow the bridging piece between laboratory environment and industrial environment. As you can see it here, we have different machineries in different sizes, and all this machinery is scalable to industrial size. And this kiln represents, is a very good example for the scaling that we do here at IKTS. So I hope you enjoyed this very short lab tour, and I hope I could give you some impressions about the work at IKTS related to sodium batteries. Yes, my team is working on this technology for almost 6 years now, and I really hope that we will bring this technology to the market in the next 2, maybe 3 years. And if you have any questions, if I can do anything for you, please contact me. Do not hesitate in contacting me. I'm looking forward to your comments, to your questions, and yes, see you in the next session.